This is my golf putter robot. It breaks almost every rule the PGA has on putters. It uses motors, electromagnets, lasers, artificial intelligence, a sprinkle of physics to aim and sink putts. About the only thing that is legal with this putter is the angle of the handle, so I think we're good to use it. There's a wide variety of allowed shapes and sizes of putters in golf, but they all roughly do the same thing. They just hit the ball and you hope it goes in the hole. But we're gonna go a different route. We're gonna build a robot that finds the hole, does all the math on where to aim and how hard to hit the ball, and with the press of a button, sink it. But before we hit any shots, let's roll back and see how we got here. Like most of my projects, this turned out to be a doozy. It had some major redesigns, a lot of testing, a ton of code, and even though I had a lot of help, I still had a ton of problems.
Oh, I made a mistake. Hang on.
Okay, putting a golf ball seems so simple. I mean, you just aim and hit. But anyone who's ever tried it can tell you that the devil is in the details. How much room do you actually have while you're aiming? Let's say that the ball is roughly 3 meters or 10 feet away from the hole. You have to strike the ball within plus or minus 1 degree of normal to make it in. On top of all that, you gotta judge how hard to hit the ball to even make it in too. Let's start off with our first requirement. We want to hit the ball at most 3 meters. And a pendulum seems like the perfect solution. A weight raised to the same height will always strike the ball with the same amount of force, so the ball should end up in the same spot. The first thing we need to know is how hard to hit the ball. So I went up in the attic and I grabbed an old putter, laid down a ruler, and started hitting some balls. By recording hitting those balls, we can analyze the footage and determine how fast the ball was actually going. This will give me a good starting point on how high to lift the putter to hit the ball 3 meters. I started designing version 1, and honestly, it was a hot mess. I'm not even going to go into the details of how it worked because I overcomplicated that thing, and I'm pretty certain it would never work. Version 2, however, revolved around the idea of using an electromagnet to release the putter. As long as electricity flows into the magnet, the putter would be held. And once we stop flowing the electricity, it's free to swing and all that kinetic energy goes into the ball. So let's build a test fixture to confirm that the electromagnet I ordered is strong enough to pick up the putter.
Nice.
Let's see how consistent this thing is. That'll do. Now that we can hit the ball up to 3 meters, we need to start looking at how we're going to find the hole. We're going to solve this by looking for the flagpole. The sensor I chose for locating the hole is called a LiDAR. It's basically a laser and a sensor that counts how long it takes for the light to bounce back. The hole assembly is spinning, so with a given distance and an angle of rotation, the sensor will calculate a point in 2D space. I originally planned on using a LiDAR that I took out of an old robot vacuum that I bought at a thrift store years ago. But when I saw these newer ones on eBay, I couldn't help myself. I ended up ordering 4 of them for like 50 bucks. Plus, look at the size difference. Okay, let's wire up the LiDAR to a microcontroller and start reading the data. You can see the Advil bottle moving in the LiDAR data as I move it back and forth. If you look at some data points and you squint your eyes just a little bit, you can intuitively start to group the points together. That's pretty much what a clustering algorithm does. There's a really nice one that simulates our intuition called HDB scan. It's pretty much magic. We know that the flagpole is 19 millimeters in diameter, so we can just ignore any clusters that are too big or too small. I couldn't really find an implementation of HDB scan that would work on a microcontroller, and I really didn't want to implement it from the white paper, so I did the next best thing. I asked ChatGPT to do it for me. I mean, it got me 90% of the way there. I didn't have to write it from scratch. I just needed to add a little bit of filtering logic and it was good to go. I printed off this mock target. It's the same diameter as the flagpole, so I can just move that around and test out the clustering algorithm. And voila, I was clustering the LiDAR data and I was finding the flag using the microcontroller. Okay, so we can hit the ball 3 meters and we have the ability to locate the flag. We need to merge those two and figure out how we're gonna aim left to right. Figuring out how to aim was quite the problem. I thought about this for a while, and I sketched out a lot of harebrained ideas. Most of them I knew would never work, but what I ultimately settled on is a mechanism similar to a rear-end differential in a car. By mirroring the two gears, we can move them at the same time to lift the magnet, or we can move them in opposite directions to rotate the lift arm to twist the putter. Let's get building. It wasn't long before I hit my first problem. I didn't simulate the swing of the putter, and I immediately noticed that it hits the front leg of the robot kind of violently. Between a slow printer, running out of filament, and a power outage, it took a few days, but I finally got some parts. Let's get this thing back together. I got everything assembled and started working on the firmware to lift the arms. It went pretty smoothly, except for when you update the firmware. While it's updating, the pins are in an uncontrolled state and the motors just freak out. We'll come back to that. I also noticed that the magnet couldn't hold the putter while it was being lifted. I tried slowing down the lifting motors to be a little more gentle, and that held the putter better, but it still would just let go occasionally. That's just not gonna cut it. Because we have up to 18 volts from the battery, I looked on Amazon and found a 24 volt magnet that was 4 times stronger than the other one. Since I'm not varying the power supplied to the magnet, I can get away with a simple relay board. And I really need 2 boards to control the power to the electromagnet and to control the power to the servo motors. I guess I could, or I could just order one. The new relay board controls the magnet and cuts the power to the motors during upload, so we don't have that nasty upload bug anymore. While I was wiring in the new relay board, I wasn't paying attention and I wired the converter backwards. This sent the full 18 volts from the batteries into all the 5 volt electronics. I got pretty lucky. The only thing that it got was the microcontroller, and that's pretty easy to swap out, so let's get rid of this. After swapping out the microcontroller and uploading the firmware, everything seems to be working. My helper's been wanting to play with this thing, so I'm just gonna program it to hit it at like 70%, and I'm gonna have an evening and playing in the shop.
I'm ready. Alright, push the button. Let's see what happens. Mm-hmm. What do you think is gonna happen?
I don't know.
Alright, try it.
Up until this point, the main part of the shop wasn't available because of a large project that was going on. But now that that's out of the way, let's build a proper putting mat out in the center of the shop. Okay, we can hit the ball 3 meters, we can aim plus or minus 10 degrees, we can find the hole. The last piece of the puzzle is to determine how hard to hit the ball. About the easiest way I could come up with is to hit the ball at various powers and record how far they went at that power. Now that we have a bunch of power to distance tuples, we can fit a line to it. Once we have that line, we have the ability to look up how much power is required to hit a ball a specific distance. However, there is a gotcha. Look at this shot of the robot hitting the ball left, right, and center. Notice how the ball goes much further down the center at the same power. That's because we're losing a lot of energy with the putter at an angle, so the ball doesn't go as far. You can see the lower putter get twisted back straight, so that means that some of the energy is going back into the putter and not entirely into the ball. This footage is 4,000 frames per second, and you can see very quickly that the ball on the right, which is going straight, is going much faster than the ball on the left. But we're going to solve that by bumping up the power in the firmware the more we aim it off center.
I love learning. The reason I make these videos and I make these robots is because I'm teaching myself engineering and physics, which brings me to today's sponsor.
Brilliant's an online learning platform where you basically learn the same way that I do out here in the shop, by doing. The lessons are not video lectures. You learn by interacting with hands-on lessons. You really retain what you learn. There are concepts integrated into this robot that I learned over a year ago. You don't have to sit down at a computer for hours either. Their mobile app allows you to do a daily lesson on the go or whenever you have a spare 5 minutes. They have thousands of lessons ranging from math, data, programming, even AI, designed to build your skill set and intuition. If you're curious like me about ChatGPT, Brilliant lets you peek under the hood of large language models like ChatGPT to understand the concepts powering today's technology. To try everything Brilliant has to offer for free for a full 30 days, visit brilliant.org/sparksandcode. There's a link in the description, or you can scan the QR code. If you use either of those two links, you'll get 20% off your annual premium subscription. All right, let's see how this thing does. Thank you.
This was a lot of fun to build. I mean, wasn't too bad on the problems this time around. Must be getting a little better. So rewarding to just push a button and sink a putt. Like, my son loves it. All of his little buddies were playing with it over the weekend. It's a good time. But this is the kind of stuff you're into. Be sure to like and subscribe, and I'm going to keep making more. So I'll catch you on the next one.